Hi folks, Artist Mac here, and on the eve of my switch over to a new cell phone, I thought I'd go through a little of my cell phone history, which starts back in 1995 when I got a Motorola Microtac. Yes, kiddies, in 1995, this was considered a portable phone. Now, this was an improvement over the phone before it, the Motorola Dyna-Tac, which was so big and so heavy, it was nicknamed the Brick. And back in those days, this phone was advertised as pocketable, easy to use, and dependable. In reality, it was none of those. But it was a start. It wasn't very good with like long distance phone calls or calls you had to make from enclosed spaces. I mean, there were a lot of dead zones. The one call that I got on it that was ever really crucial, because hardly any calls on cell phones are crucial, was my dad was in the hospital. What did he have? Congestive heart failure. And he was dying, and they needed to give him a blood transfusion, and did we have any moral or religious objections? So, anyway, we had this one for 5 years, and then switched over to this Nokia. And I can't think of the model number right now. Is it even on here somewhere? No. It's probably in the case. But anyway, for the time, very good phone. Portable. It really was easy to use. I actually made a call from the Orange Empire Railway Museum in Perris, California, that's P-E-R-R-I-S, to L.A. Union Station to find out what time my train left, you know, if it was being delayed, because I was going to be late getting back there. So, worked great. Very happy with this phone. Had it, again, for 5 years. In 2005, I dropped it and it broke, which led me to my next phone. The Motorola V60i. Now this and the Nokia were both track phones. It's a very basic phone service where at the time, you paid for a card that had a certain number of minutes on it, and you could call up and have the minutes added to your phone. Worked great, very cheap. I don't think I ever paid more than about $30 a month. You know, I'd pay for like a 60-minute card, and that would last me the month. I mean, I'm not a big cell phone caller. So, the problem with this one, it started getting to the place where there were dead zones, you know, just everywhere. So I had to retire this one. You know, I was sorry to say, it was a very good phone for me. The next one was the Blackberry Pearl Flip. This was my very first BlackBerry, and it was the phone that made me fall in love with BlackBerry. You know, this was the first one that, you know, had the icons, you know, where you could take pictures, set an alarm, look at your emails, you know, all the things that we're used to doing with phones now. It eliminated the problem of the dead zones. This one was from T-Mobile, Now, the reason I got rid of this one was TracFone was giving me a hard time about mailing my bill to a post office box because I was having a lot of trouble with the mail carrier just leaving mail sticking out of my mail slot. And I couldn't have that because, you know, I'm getting checks, I'm getting bills. You know, I can't risk somebody just coming along, you know, behind the mail person and going zzzz out of the mail slot. So, you know, I got myself a post office box, spent a very long day calling everybody in creation, you know, who was sending me bills, sending me checks, any important mail, to make sure that they had the address changed to that P.O. box. T-Mobile was the only one who absolutely would not send mail to P.O. boxes. Now, I learned afterwards, long afterwards, that I could have circumvented this by just telling them, you know, that my address was now the name of my, you know, the address of my post office. You know, don't tell them that. And unit number, whatever your post office box is. You know, it works with eBay, it works with Amazon. They don't know the difference. But anyway, my next phone after this was you guessed it, another BlackBerry. And this was the BlackBerry Torch 9800. A lot more advanced and larger than the Pearl. Again, you know, takes wonderful pictures, wonderful video. You know, again, emails, great. I was never much listening to music, but I really started listening to music with this phone. You know, they've got the, they got the earphone jack right over here. And so I just plugged it in and, you know, went to town. But one thing that I never do with phones, I'm never just walking down the street with the earphones in, not paying attention, because that's the fastest way to get robbed, as people have found recently on Chicago streets. Now, when I switched, where'd the thing go? When I switched from the Pearl Flip to the Torch, I also switched from T-Mobile to AT&T, who I am still with. And, you know, it's been good. I mean, you know, it's a cell phone. Let's see. After this, about 2 years later, I got the BlackBerry Torch 9810. There we go. And on this one, you could actually see the icons. It's basically the same as the 9800, whose battery is dead, of course, after 7 years. Except that the icons on the 9810 were basically outlines, and the icons on this one are a lot more three-dimensional. But, you know, worked great, enjoyed it. The problem with BlackBerries is, even when I got this one in 2012, let's see, and this one was 2010, there was a perception that BlackBerries were dead, BlackBerries are going out of business, you know, da-da-da-da. So, nobody was making apps for them, and apps were just starting to really become popular, you know, with the popularity of the iPhone and the Android. And I was finding that apps that I really wanted, I couldn't get. So, I got the phone that I have now, Blackberry Classic. Now, I had gotten this one on the promise that it would be able to download Android apps. More on this phone in another video.